Hello, good afternoon students. In previous class we have studied short lines EPCD parameters evaluation as well as medium transmission line by using nominal T method. In today's class we have to go for nominal pi method for EPCD evaluation and some related problems. It is already known that in nominal pi method the capacitance is placed at two ends. 50% of capacitance is placed nearer to sending end side and 50% of capacitance is placed nearer to receiving end side as shown in figure, and series impedance is total. R be the resistance of line for phase and XL be the inductive reactance of the line per phase, and as usual Vs is sending end voltage and Vr is receiving end voltage for phase system, and IC1 and IC2 be the current flows through the capacitance. IC1 is the current flows through the capacitance which is nearer to receiving end side. Similarly, IC2 is the capacitance current nearer to sending end side, and IR is the load current or receiving end current. You can observe voltage VR is available across C1. Hence, by knowing the capacitive susceptance, knowing the VR, you can determine IC1, and by the load condition of the power and power factor, then it is possible to calculate IR. Hence, vector sum IC1 and IR gives line current IL. Hence, after determining the IL, VR plus voltage drop of series impedance, that is IL into R plus JXL or IL into Z, gives your VS. Some basic ideas you should remember. After knowing the IL, you come for calculation of Vs, that is Vr plus I into Z, Z equal to R plus XL. And once you are knowing the Vs, this voltage is available across capacitance C2. Hence, you are knowing the capacitive susceptance, then you are knowing the IL, you are knowing the Vs, then capacitive susceptance, go for the calculation of IC2. Once IC2 comes, we are knowing the IL, go for IS. These are all preliminary calculation from the equivalent circuit diagram only. Same thing you proceed. Let total impedance equal to R plus JXL, where R is total resistance of the line per phase, XL is total inductive reactance per phase. Y, capacitive susceptance, equal to J omega C. C is the capacitance value and omega, that is 2 phi F. Then current, sending end current, IS equal to IL plus IC2, where IC2 equal to Vs into pi by 2. And line current, IL equal to IR plus IC1. IR plus IC1, that should be equal to Vr into pi by 2. So, once you are knowing the line current, then it is very easy to determine sending end voltage per phase. So, Vs equal to Vr plus impedance drop, that is IL into Z. So, you calculate Vs. Vs equal to Vr plus IR, terms you separate. First you make the multiplication common factor, then you make the concentration of Vr related sides one side and IR related values one side. So it becomes 1 plus YZ by 2 common into Vr and Z into IR, develop the equation 1, and IS equal to IL plus IC2. We are knowing the IL. Hence, IC2 equal to y by 2 into phi s. Hence finally I s equal to, we are getting multiply again same thing, V r terms you multiply, I r terms you multiplied, so it becomes y plus y square z divided by 4 into V r, all V r related terms one side, then 1 plus y z by 2 times of I r, develop the equation 2, then you compare these two equations with generalized constant standard expressions, that is V s equal to A times of V r plus B times of I r, then I s equal to C times of V r plus D times of I r, then you write down very easily A, B, C, D values. You write all two expressions, general expressions, V s equal to A times of V r plus B times of I r, and I s equal to C times of V r plus D times of I r, and compare our nominal pi method expressions and write the values. A equal to D equal to 1 plus y z by 2, that is B equal to z, hence C equal to y in common factors 1 plus y z by 4 inside the bracket. So this derivation is very important. By using nominal pi method, obtain the ABCD values and also show that AD minus BC equal to 1. It is number of times asked in PTU question paper. Hence, step number 1, A value and D value already we are knowing. Hence, A equal to D. A equal to D. Hence, the given network is symmetrical. One condition is what? Second condition, you are having the values A, D and B, C. You multiply AD and multiply BC minus. You substitute values A value, D value minus B value and C value. Multiply, simply general terms multiply, then finally we are going to get 1. Up to here you can go for. If question comes AD minus BC equal to 1, show means here, or calculate the ABCD parameters means top. It may be for 8 marks. Then related one problem on T method. A 110 kV 50 Hz 3-phase transmission line delivers a load of 40 MW at 0.8 power factor lagging at receiving end. The generalized constants of the transmission line are A equal to D equal to 0.95 with an angle 1.4, B equal to 96 with 78 ohms angle, C equal to 0.0015 with an angle 90 mho. Find the regulation of the line and charging current by using nominal T method. It is usual question. So already you are knowing given voltage is line voltage. Given voltage is line voltage, and expressions we are using, that is in phase voltage, always you remember. So receiving end voltage given is line voltage. So calculate receiving end phase voltage divided by root 3. Then receiving end current by using receiving end power and receiving end power factor. Receiving end power is given 40 megawatt, and 3 times of Vr into cos pi r. You see there, you go for calculation, so you are going to get as 247 ampere. Then you calculate the IR with complex numbers, magnitude is 247, then cos inverse of 0.85, angle becomes 31.78. Then sending end voltage equal to A times Vr plus B times of IR. A times of Vr plus B times of IR. So already ABCD values are given. You substitute VR and IR and AB value. Just it is conversion of polar to rectangular, rectangular to polar. So you calculate VS sending end voltage per phase. We are going to get as 78.94 kilovolts. Similarly, we have to go for sending end current C times of VR plus D times of IR. Again, say thing, CD values are given, VR, IR values, you substitute. Here only one thing, IS equal to 203.77, angle is 6.59. Here make a correction, this angle is minus 6.59. So IS lags VR, minus angle means IS lags the vector VR by an angle of 6.59. It is a lagging angle. In nominal T method, IS equal to IC plus IR. Therefore, charging current equal to IS minus IR. You are knowing IS, you are knowing IR. Calculate that. Charging current we are going to get as 106.94. You see, it is asked in problem. In another one, voltage regulation. So voltage regulation equal to receiving end side voltage, that is load side voltage, no load voltage minus load voltage divided by load voltage. No load receiving end voltage VR naught minus load voltage VR receiving end voltage. But here VR naught, no load receiving end voltage, may be replaced by VS by A. May be replaced. It is equivalent to that value. Therefore, VS by A. A you take only magnitude. VS also you take only magnitude. Again, a care should be taken. VS and VR should be of both units. Kilovolt, kilovolt. Either volt, volt. Hence, 78.94. It is for phase value. A value magnitude is 0.95 and VR for phase 63.50. Hence, voltage regulation finally we are getting 30.86. Sir, first you practice ABCD parameter by nominal pi method. Circuit diagram, these formulas, vector diagram. It may be asked for number of times in exam for 8 to 10 marks. Hence, thank you to one and all.